largely in Sun Belt, but could be spreading. My team is also working night and day with Capitol Hill to advance the next economic relief package. We're working very hard on it. We're making a lot of progress. I also know that both sides want to get it done. We'll call it phase four. I think we're going to get it done. We'll protect our workers, our schools, and our families, and protect them very strongly. As one family, we mourn every precious life that's been lost. I pledge in their honor that we will develop a vaccine and we will defeat the virus. We're doing very well with vaccine development and therapeutic development. But I want to thank our brave doctors and nurses and frontline responders. The job they do is incredible, and they are truly brave. My administration will stop at nothing to save lives and shield the vulnerable, which is so important. We've learned so much about this disease, and we know who the vulnerable are, and we are going to indeed shield them. And again, the vaccines are coming, and they're coming a lot sooner than anyone thought possible, by years. If you look at the old system and look at the new system, I think by years. The China virus is a vicious and dangerous illness, but we've learned a great deal about it and who it targets. We are in the process of developing a strategy that's going to be very, very powerful. We've developed them as we go along. Some areas of our country are doing very well. Others are doing less well. It will probably, unfortunately, get worse before it gets better. Something I don't like saying about things, but that's the way it is. It's the way, it's what we have. You look over the world, it's all over the world. And it tends to do that. The governors are working very, very hard, and we are supporting them 100%. Everything they need, they get. And we are taking good care. We have tremendous supplies and a great supply chain, whether it's ventilators or gowns or just about anything they need. So that's a big difference from inheriting very, very empty cupboards. The median age of those who succumb to the China virus is 78 years old. Roughly half of all deaths have been individuals in nursing homes or long-term care. In one study, 90% of those hospitalized had underlying medical conditions, whether it's heart or diabetes, but usually it's some kind of a condition. It seems that people have that, and if they do, it's a problem, no question about it. Young adults may often have mild or even no symptoms. They won't even know they're sick. They won't have any idea that they have a virus. They won't have any idea at all. America's youth will act responsibly, and we're asking everybody that when you are not able to socially distance, wear a mask, get a mask, whether you like the mask or not. They have an impact, they'll have an effect, and we need everything we can get. Data shows children have the lowest fatality risk. 99.96% of all virus fatalities are in adults. Think of that.